Success is a very lonely road. There are very few people who are willing to go through the pain, the hardship, the sacrifices, the agony of the process in order to succeed.
It's these moments when you feel the urge to quit. You feel the urge to say to yourself, it can't be done. I don't think I can make it. I don't think I have what it takes.
This is the point where everything's gonna go south on you. And you're gonna think, this is it for you. This is how I end. This is the end of my journey. Now you have a choice. You can accept that, or you can decide, I will not be denied. This will not be it for my life.
At some point or another, you gotta make a stand. If you're gonna change, if you're gonna improve your life, if you're gonna improve your situation, you gotta make a declaration that I will not be stopped. I'm gonna do whatever it takes. And one way or another, I will win.
Instead of backing down, instead of giving into the struggle, you push yourself forward into the unknown. You have got to proactively prepare to catch yourself. When you find yourself getting negative with people that you have allowed to push your buttons, when you find yourself becoming negative about what's happening to you and the circumstances that you're involved in, you reinforce your mind with positivity, telling yourself, everything is okay. I'm gonna get through this. This is not the end. This is only the beginning for me.
It's crucial to always be on the lookout for those moments when external factors threaten to sway our inner balance. You've got to be your own biggest supporter. Stop letting outsiders get in your head. You got to pump yourself up. Remind yourself of all that you've been through before. And these things you're facing now, they're nothing. This isn't your first dogfight, and it won't be your last.
Everybody hits that wall at one moment or another. That wall shocks most people. That wall knocks the life out of most people. That wall is painful. But the thing that separates the average people and the people who win is how they respond to that wall.
Most people choose to give in. They can't handle the sting of being hit, so they fold. But there are some rare individuals who decide, I will not give up. I will not give in. And I will succeed. I will not allow the pain to beat me.
These are the people who know there is no gain without pain. There is no testimony without a trial. It is meant to be hard. That rough process is necessary in order to produce the great things in your life.
You have not seen the best days of your life yet. The greatest is still yet to come. And you must keep pushing yourself to move forward even when it hurts. Even when your legs want to give out and you're crying yourself to sleep at night and everything is fighting against you, you must keep fighting.
When it feels like the entire world is against you, I need you to reinforce your self-belief and muster yourself up, telling yourself in the mirror, you can do this. You can handle this. This challenge isn't bigger than you. You can get through this.
And when you get through this, you're gonna be bigger. You're gonna be better. You're gonna be bolder because you fought your way through it. It's only here to make you stronger.
But you have to start living your life in expectation. You have got to start expecting great things to happen for you in order for it to happen. If you expect bad things to happen, that's what's going to happen. But if you expect the best, that's exactly the direction you'll head.
Your belief is what dictates the direction you steer your life. So you have to be consciously aware of the thoughts going on in your mind, focusing only on allowing positive, productive ideas to be dwelled on in your head.
This is how winners are made. They don't allow the idea of losing to sink into their brain. They reject any thought of failure, of loss, of decline. They focus only on making improvement. They focus only on the strategies and opportunities to make their lives and other people's lives better.
No guts, no glory. You've got to be willing to face rejection and no again and again and again. Willing to face defeat again and again and again. And every time life knocks you down, you jump up and say, no matter what it takes, I will win.
It takes guts. You gotta dig down deep and gut it out. Keep on going again and again and again until you make it happen. Because you know that it's possible.
Your self-belief must outweigh others' disbelief. Your belief must be so strong that you block out the noise of everyone around you. And all you hear is your internal dialogue telling you, I can do this. I will do this. I must do this. And no matter what it takes, with everything
being, I am going to win. If you are self-motivated and self-regulated, you can have it. You can be it. You can do it.
You've got to believe in yourself. You've got to believe in your abilities. You've got to believe in your service, your company, your ideas, unquestionably.
Take that leap of faith. Trust yourself and believe. And know within yourself that everything is going to be all right.
If you've got that drive, that inner fire, then there's nothing stopping you. You can have whatever you set your mind to. Be what you dream to be. Do what you've always wanted. It all starts with you, your motivation, your discipline. Harness that and the world is yours. Keep dreaming. Keep looking at your dream. Keep focusing on your dream. Keep going after the dream, because that's where true success is.
The people that are running after their dream, they know they're gonna have hard times, but they keep on running because they're saying within themselves, I am the one and I will win.
When you're working on a business or in life, things will always go wrong. That's the human condition.
Look, we've all been quitters, everyone.
Nobody's journey is seamless or smooth. We all stumble, we all have setbacks.
The question is not if some of these things will happen to you, they will. The question is, what do we do next?
You've got to have resiliency.
If I don't quit, I can't fail. If I just simply don't quit, I cannot fail.
Hold fast. I know you want to give up. I know you want to quit. I know you're tired, but hold fast.
Some days, of course, I'll get tired. Some days, I will get beat up. Some days, I will get knocked down, and I will have some bad days. But I will not stop. This is an everyday gig. Every day is a Monday. And you might not like that. Me, I love it. To me, every day is a beginning. A new day, a new week, a new shot at life. An opportunity to come out of the gate like a man possessed and attack the day without mercy. Today, I'm putting the pressure on. I am the aggressor. I am on the attack.
You don't get this far. You don't get to this point and just stop.
Most people spend their life not wanting to deal with the pain of rejection, the pain of defeat, the pain of being disappointed, the pain of losing, the pain of failure, the pain of being criticized, the pain of not being liked, the pain. That's called life. Now, will it be turbulent? Yes. Will it be easy? No. Will you have some opposition? Yes. Will I make a lot of mistakes? Yes. Will I get hurt? Yeah. But guess what? There's no gain without pain. Don't judge the possibilities for what you can do based upon the circumstances, because the circumstances won't determine who you are. The possibilities for you are unlimited. If you're in a rebuilding process, it's unlimited. If you're coming back from adversity and devastation, it's unlimited of what you can do. Doesn't matter how many mistakes you've made. Doesn't matter how many flops you've had. I see it only as an investment of what you learn from life, of what's possible for you. Struggle, pain, misery, frustration, those are signs that you are on the right path. Nobody that is where you want to be has gotten there without these struggles, without the pain. And if you want to be something great, you are going to have to learn to accept the struggle as part of the recipe. Every single day, you need to look yourself in the mirror and ask yourself, what am I willing to do to get what I want? And if the answer is, whatever the fuck I have to, you'll get there in time.
It's necessary you take responsibility for it. That you make it happen, that you don't give up, that you don't take any objection or disappointment or defeats personally, that you keep on keeping on, that you don't decide that I can't make it because you can't see the light at the end of the tunnel, that you realize that's a part of the program. See, as long as you breathe, then you got a shot at your dream. And here's something you've got to resolve. Not over till I get through. Not over till I get over. Not over till I get what I want. Door can't open today, look out. I'm gonna come back and take the hinges off. That's how you gotta do that. You got to have that kind of courage, that type of determination. If you wanna make it happen, it's you. But you got to take personal responsibility to make it happen. We can point out many things that can make it inconvenient or can slow us down. But ultimately, it's you.
It's easy to conquer when it's good weather. You got good sleep.
Work's going good. The family's good. You feel great. Your body's not injured. Those are the easy days to conquer. But who are you on those days when all hell's broke loose? Your body's you're sore. You're depressed. You're miserable. Who are you on those days?
Of course, you don't feel like doing it. It's hard, whatever it is. And you rationalize and you justify and you make excuses like a high-priced defense attorney trying to win the case for weakness. And boy, I'll tell you what, that lawyer in your head is good. That lawyer knows just what to say. That lawyer knows all the legal loopholes and definitely knows how to sway the jury. So how do you compete with that? Don't play the game. Don't argue, don't discuss, don't negotiate. You tell that snake of a lawyer that's in your head to shut up. Tell him you don't want to hear it. Tell him you don't need to hear it because you are not the guilty party. You are in the right. You are on the side of strength and stability, and you don't need approval from this lazy lawyer to go and do what you're supposed to do.
That's the great divide. Those people who get up on those days when everything's still grind, that's the separator right there.
You don't negotiate with the weakness in your head. You get your ass up, you get moving, and you get the f after it, no matter how you feel.
What if for 10 years you didn't avoid doing what you knew you needed to do? What would your life be like? What would happen if you just stopped wasting the opportunities that are in front of you? Who knows how much more efficient you'd be? You could be 10 times more efficient, 20 times more efficient. You have no idea how efficient a human being can become when they just stop wasting all the possibilities that are in front of them.
But it takes you dealing with what you really don't want to do and doing them to the best of your ability every single time. You force yourself to execute when you know it needs to be done, setting aside your feelings about the action.
Only weak in life go after things and attempt things they already know they can achieve. You've got to do something you're not quite sure of. Try something new if you want to switch it up. That's where growth comes, man. That's where your body's forced to adapt, forced to suffer the discipline today, so you never suffer the form of regret tomorrow.
That thing that you have to do that you know sucks, well, the longer you wait, the longer it takes. Don't let that happen. Go on the attack, go get it done.
There's no room for half-assed attempts. It's a full throttle, no bullshit kind of deal. The kind where you look adversity in the eyes and say, bring it on.
You see, greatness doesn't come to those who cower in the face of challenge. It's the prize for the relentless, the unstoppable.
You force yourself to suffer the pain of discipline so you never suffer the pain of regret. Because that pain of discipline will last for minutes, but that pain of regret will last a lifetime. Do not allow that to happen. Do what's hard now and live an easy life in the future, investing in today for a better tomorrow.
Look in the mirror and declare on the part of you that's holding you back. No more excuses, no more procrastination, no more self-sabotage. That ends today.
You get pissed off when others let you down, but what about when you let yourself down? You give yourself a free pass. You're not where you should be financially, physically, mentally, and you just let it slide. That. It's time to hold yourself accountable.
Sometimes you gotta tell yourself no. No more TV, no more bullshit snacks, no more desserts. It's time to work out your body and your mind. Cut out the crap that's numbing you. Alcohol. Not now. You can't handle distractions right now. You owe yourself more than that.
I challenge you for the rest of this year to push yourself like never before.
Dive all in.
Every second, every minute, every day, become consumed by that vision and let nothing pull you away from it.
Stop pretending you can have your way to greatness. Dedicate every breath, every ounce of energy, every thought to becoming what you want to be. Nothing great comes from comfort. Everything worth having comes from the uncomfortable, the struggle, the grind.
Night or day, it doesn't matter. What matters is your dedication. While your buddies are out there wasting their lives, you should be building yours. Success doesn't care about weekends or holidays, and neither should you. You work until you get what you want, and you don't stop until then.
Pain is temporary, but quitting will forever. You think champions have it easy? No, they fight, claw, and scream their way to the top. Every scar, every wound is a testament to their battle. Be that warrior. Be that never backs down.
So ask yourself, are you going to be a footnote or a legend? Will you let life happen to you, or will you happen to life? The clock's ticking and time waits for no one. Seize this moment, this day, this opportunity.
If you want it bad enough, you find a way. If you don't want it bad enough, you find an excuse. The person that finishes the race with their hand held isn't it about how big they are, how tough they are, their potential, their perseverance. It's not about the dog that's in the fight. It's the fight within the dog. Well, yeah, it's a shit situation. I gotta go to work because I gotta pay the bills and support my family. But you know, it doesn't mean I have to shortcut my success in what I'm doing. I'll find a way to work this out. Even if you fail, you get back up and you continue to try and fail, continue to try and fail, and ensuring you never fail to try.
Telling yourself that you don't need to go harder, or you don't need to do more in your job, or be more disciplined in the way that you live. If you tell yourself those things, that's actually a lie. Because you know you can do more. You know you can be more. And that's the truth. That's the truth, and it eats you up.
When you get content, when you settle, somebody's chasing you, somebody's coming from behind, and somebody's trying to take your spot. And so every single day when you wake up, you gotta set new goals, new benchmarks, you gotta raise it higher and higher and higher so you can make your dreams become a reality.
No complacency. No complacency. No backing off. No slack whatsoever. Fight.
If you're a student in school, try harder, study harder, and focus more. You got this! That athlete that's out there and you're not training how you're supposed to, go 10, 15 minutes harder, 5, 10 more reps.
You have to work when no one's watching. You have to train like there is no tomorrow, day after day after day. You can improve just a little bit every day.
That's the effort you need to be great. That's the sacrifice that you have to put in order for you to get to the next level that you need to be at. You think I won't make it? Try me. I will stand up to any task, any day, anywhere. I've been a failure before. Now it's time for me to succeed. I've been without, and I'm hungry for success.
Am I satisfied? Not by a long shot. And I will not go quietly until the night. I will go kicking and screaming.
Every opportunity is the last opportunity. Every opportunity, I have to reprove myself again. Because the day you become content is the day you die, is the day the person who's trying to catch you will get you. The problem is that most people, they can't get up in the morning. They ain't got no energy. They don't got the energy to keep up with me. I'm like, boo, ain't nothing wrong with you. You just ain't got the stamina. You just ain't got the energy. You can't smart everything. You can't outthink everything. Some stuff is just you gotta be powerful. It's just some stuff that you gotta have stamina for. You just too slow. It just take you too long. You wake up, take you 3 weeks to do what it can take 24 hours to do. It don't make you a bad person, but you don't forever be average, because to be great, you got to keep up. No alarm clock needed. My passion wakes me up. My drive wakes me up. My ability to be, do, and act whatever I want, it wakes me up. What wakes you up? What drives you? Why are you playing this game? You gotta begin with the end in mind. So whatever your dream or your goal is, you gotta wake up every day to it. You gotta go to bed with it. You gotta read stuff. The music you listen to, everything you do, gotta pour into that dream. You don't belong at the bottom, and it's time for you to get your butt from down there. It's time for you to stop being comfortable at the bottom. Get your butt up and get to where you're supposed to be. Get where you belong. Do what you're supposed to do. Live like you're supposed to live. You gotta. Every single day of my life, I feel like giving 120. Every single day, I don't have days where I don't feel like it. Why? Because I'm counting on me. My wife's counting on me. My son's counting on me. I don't have days to waste. And your grind has to match your dream. You can't play as much as you used to play. You can't go where you used to go. You can't do what you used to do. And now you gotta pick your grind up. And I need you to wake up every single day, and I need you to use your 24 hours like you've never used it before.
Most people, ladies and gentlemen, are stoppable. Most people, all you have to do is tell them no. All you have to do is make it inconvenient for them. All you have to do is throw some issues and challenges their way, and they give up. They throw in the towel. They surrender.
See, those people don't realize that it goes with the territory. That when you want to grow, when you want to achieve, when you want to experience more, all hell will break loose. Everything that can happen will happen.
It's one thing to believe when you've got money in your pocket. It's one thing to believe when your marriage is working out and you've got your health. It's easy to believe then. But it's another thing when you get that diagnosis that says you're not going to be around much longer. When you lose your job, when someone you thought you'd be with for the rest of your life says, no, we can't do this anymore. That's when you have to dig deep. That's when you got to find something within you that won't be denied.
There is something about you. There is a power within you that regardless of what happens to you, you can stand up inside of yourself and declare, I am going to do it.
You got to get to the point in your life where you say, I have had it. I'm not going to live like this anymore. No, there's got to be more for me. You got to draw the line. You got to say enough is enough, and I'm not going to let anything stop me.
Don't go through life feeling like you're powerless. Victims are people that are powerless. You're not powerless. You're not a victim. You are powerful. In the chaos is an opportunity. If you can learn to harness the pain you're going through, you can rise to the challenge and refuse to allow the chaos around you to determine the conqueror within you.
Resisting the toe to go down and standing fiercely in spite of the opposition and saying, I'm going to do it anyway, but you don't know what's happened to me. It doesn't matter what has happened to you. The only thing that really matters is what are you going to do about it?
I can become upset, nervous, tense about it, weak about it, or I can say, it's okay, I'm going to make it happen. You can allow it to destroy you, or you can allow it to build you up. You have the power to do that.
Things are going to happen to you, and the most important thing to do is to harness your will and let it go and move so you can grow, so you can get on with your life. Start working and developing yourself now and prepare yourself for what it is that you want because you expect to get it.
Courageously hold on to your dream and don't lose enthusiasm. You got to be out of your mind to believe. In spite of these numbers, you can still make it. You got to be crazy. Yes, you must be crazy. The crazy people are the only ones who change the world and do the impossible. You got to believe in your heart of hearts that in spite of the pain you're feeling, you can still come back again. It doesn't matter how many times I fail. I'm going to courageously pursue it. I don't care what people say. I don't care what they think. This is something that I want that gives my life meaning and value.
You've got to learn how not to give up and how not to give in. And you got to understand that greatness is within you and you got to pull it out. When life's putting the pressure on you, you have to learn to bolt every escape hatch closed in your mind and don't allow yourself a way out. You gotta find a way or make a way.
It's okay to cry, it's okay to go home, it's okay to take a break, but quitting should never be an option. The weakness is in your mind. Out to worry you to death, out to stress you to death, out to break you down, out to make you quit, out to make you think that you can't get up, out to make you give up on your dream.
The war takes place in your own head. It's not in your savings account. It's not in your job. The fight that you've got to fight is in your mind. And if you can get it out of your head, you can get it out of your job. You can get it out of your finances. You can get all the self-pitying and victimizing thoughts out of your entire life.
If you don't like where you're at, don't worry about it. This is just a chapter. Don't like how you feel right now? It's okay. It's just a chapter. Why are you up all night, stressed, worried, and weeping over one chapter in your life? This isn't the end of your story. The last chapter of your life hasn't been written yet. You still have more to go. You can still turn things around. And it doesn't matter what happened yesterday or the day before. What matters is, what are you doing right now to make your life better? What steps are you taking right now to improve yourself and your situation? We can't control what has happened, but we can control what we do now. You have full control over yourself and your ability to work on yourself and get better at whatever you're doing. The difficulties you're facing right now aren't there to stop you from living your dream. They're there to push you onto another level. They will help make you into the person you want to be. Don't run away from the hardship like most people do. Step toward it, face it head on, and be willing to wrestle with it to get what you want.
This world is always going to give you scars, and that's nothing to be ashamed of. Many people try to hide their scars. No, you should wear those scars as a badge of honor. They show what you've overcame, what you've faced and beaten, because only the toughest people make it through to the other side where success is. And you are tough. You are cut from a different cloth.
And you gotta see yourself capable and worthy of living a life of greatness, a life of peace. Say to yourself, I'm gonna do it. I'm coming out of this. I don't know how long it's gonna take. I don't know what I'm gonna have to go through. I don't know what I'm gonna lose along the way, but I am going to make it through this.
I've been broke, busted, and disgusted, but I still believe that I am coming out of this mess. No matter what it takes, I'm going to do it.
What is the common denominator of failure? Why are you failing?
You never say, because of me.
Oh, it's the competition. If you wake up tomorrow morning and blame your failure on someone or something else, you have no reason to change, do you? But if you woke up in the morning and looked in the mirror and said, I am failing because of me, the decisions that I make, the energy I put in, I'm not passing the blame. If you look in the mirror tomorrow and say that, you will change. Because nobody likes thinking of themselves as a failure.
Winners win and losers lose. And if you create a culture of losing, if you keep being a victim, if you keep letting losing happen to you, if you keep letting people do you and treat you any kind of way, it's going to become a culture.
Take ownership. Take ownership of everything in your world, the good and the bad. Don't make excuses. Don't blame any other person or any other thing. Take ownership of your mistakes. Take ownership of your shortfalls. Take ownership of your problems. And then take ownership of the solutions that will get those problems solved. Take ownership of your job, of your team, of your future, and take ownership of your life.
All I need you to do is speak up and say, I expect to win. Declare that it's over, that yesterday was the last day that you were a loser. Like yesterday was the last day you expected to come up short. When you set out for a goal, expect it to happen. Expect to be successful. Expect it to be positive. If you can expect it, if you can wake up feeling like a winner, if you can wake up talking like a winner, if you can expect that everything you do will come out winning, I guarantee you, you never ever have to come up short again.
It's not easy, but through practice and practice and practice, practice makes improvement. You can always better your best. You can always go beyond anything that you have ever done. You'll never hit a state of perfection. You're always bigger than what you do. And so all you're looking for are new breakthroughs through practice and practice and practice. You'll get better and better and better.
It might be year 2, 3, 4 before you get your big win, but you could decide now, I'm gonna walk, talk, and be a different person. You decide that. You're the lead character in the story of your life. Everything has to do with you intending to win. Too many of you are playing with your business. If you make that shift, I'm going to win. We're gonna play to win now. We're not playing to play. We're not playing to see how we do. We're not playing for fun. Once you start getting some winning, you start changing. You talk different, you walk different. All of a sudden, this isn't the same damn human being. You can change you. You'd be surprised what a little winning would do. You'd be surprised how good you'd be if you just decide to win. Be number one in your office, number one in your region. And when you start stacking them up, your life can change.
Have you ever had a moment where it feels like everything's going against you? It feels like the weight of the world has fallen on your shoulders. You're thinking about quitting. You're thinking about giving up.
It's hard. It's hard living your dream. It's hard changing your life. Once you've been knocked out by life, it's hard to pull yourself together and go back again.
You're gonna make a lot of mistakes. You're gonna have a lot of failures. You're gonna have a lot of struggles. You're gonna feel dumb and ask questions and don't know what to do or where to go.
You gotta know why you're out here, because you're gonna get your kicked by life. When the storms of life come, and they're gonna come, when life pounces on you, And that's gonna happen when it catches you on the blind side and drops you to your knees. And that's gonna happen when your plans don't work out, when you start running out of money, when you wanna give up. Your reasons will be your source of strength that will comfort you. Your reasons are the things that will help you get back up and try once again.
That moment of extreme adversity is the best moment for audacity. It's the moment where you can flip everything and turn every trial you have right now into treasure.
Sometimes you need to step back, meditate, and recharge. Sometimes you gotta go away for a little while. Clear your head, view your situation from a different angle, and try another approach.
Don't ever claim that you're a failure. You're only ever a failure when you stop trying. Thomas Edison said, "I have not failed. I've just found 10,000 ways that won't work." As long as you're trying, you have another chance to win.
Don't allow your emotions to control you. We are emotional creatures, but you gotta learn to discipline your emotions, discipline your thinking, staying focused on the goal, and not allowing your feelings and unproductive thoughts to get in the way of your progress. If you don't discipline and control your emotions and thoughts, they will use you.
You must have faith. You gotta believe in yourself. You gotta believe in your abilities, your ideas, your vision, unquestionably. And when you get punched in the face by life and you feel broken inside, you gotta be able to say to yourself, "I've got to do this. This is what I'm supposed to do. This is why I showed up." You gotta talk to yourself day in and day out, selling yourself on you and on your potential.
And all I want you to do every day is just say to yourself, when you feel that inner negative conversation saying, "You can't do it," you gotta shut that voice down. Tell it to shut up. Tell yourself, "I can handle this. I can do this. I can get through this." I want you to stand up inside of yourself and demand that no matter how many failures I endure, I must keep going. No matter how many rejections I have to face, I must keep going. Regardless of the trials and tribulations that come against me, I must keep going.
You get up every day, you look in the mirror, and you tell yourself, "I'm a bad," and one way or another, I'm gonna make it happen today. This challenge I'm facing, this pain I'm going through, this is a test. This is the day I'm gonna find out if my goals really are my goals.
You're gonna get up, you're gonna get dressed, you're gonna get out, and you're gonna do what you've been called to do. You're gonna be what you've been called to be. And you're gonna prove to everybody that tried to break you, everybody that tried to stop you, everybody that tried to kill your dream, you're gonna prove all of them wrong. I'm gonna show them all they're wrong because I'm the champion. I'm gonna prove I'm the greatest. There will never be another like me.
Champions aren't born. They're made through grit, sweat, and unwavering self-belief.
It's not about luck. It's about relentless dedication to your craft. When you step out that door, it's not just another day. It is an opportunity to unleash your greatness upon the world. You're not here to settle for mediocrity or to follow the crowd. No, you're here to lead, to set the pace, to show the world what's possible when you refuse to accept anything less than your best.
It's about digging deep and understanding that greatness resides within you. You've got to summon it, sometimes even with tears in your eyes. But under no circumstance can you throw in the towel or surrender. The enemy isn't out there. It's in your head, scheming to mess with your mind, to drown you in worries and stress and break your spirit.
If you conquer it in your head, you'll conquer it everywhere else. So cry it out if you must. Rest it out if you must. Take a break if you must. Regroup, replan, but never let that fiery belief within you extinguish. It doesn't matter how long it takes or what you have to endure along the way. You're coming out of this mess, and you're coming out stronger, wiser, and more determined than ever before.
I've been through the depths of despair, hit rock bottom, and felt the sting of defeat. But guess what? I still believe I'm coming out on top. And you should too, because that unwavering belief, that unbreakable spirit, is what sets champions apart. So keep pushing, keep fighting, and keep believing, because there's no force in this world that can stand against the power of the determined human spirit. You can delay it, but you cannot destroy it. And as long as you keep moving forward, as long as you can muster enough strength to hold on and hold out, you will see yourself become victorious.
When you feel like giving up, don't. when you thinking about giving up, don't. When it look like you ain't gonna make it, keep going. When they tell you you can't, who are they? When they tell you you're not gonna make it, don't believe them, man. You got to be relentless.
If I can take it, I can make it.
The real challenge of growth comes when you get knocked down. How you handle it. For those of you that have experienced some hardships, don't give up on your dream.
You keep standing. No matter how rough the sea, you keep standing. No matter what, you don't give up. Person that gets up off the canvas and keeps growing, that's the person that will continue to grow their influence.
You want to be persistent about what it is that you want to achieve. Alexander Graham Bell said, "What this power is, I cannot say. All I know is that it exists and it becomes available only when a man or a woman is in that state of mind in which he or she knows exactly what he or she wants and is fully determined not to quit until they find it." You have got to make a declaration that this is what you stand for. You're standing up for your dreams. You're standing up for peace of mind. You're standing up for health. You want it, and you're gonna go all out to have it. Yes, you have a dream, and the process is not supposed to be comfortable. So if it hurts, if you feel like you're under heat, if you feel like you're being pressured, welcome to the big leagues. When God looks like he's pulling you back, eventually he's gonna let you go. And the farther he pulls you back, once he releases you, boom! The power to hold on in spite of everything, the power to endure, the hunger, the ability to face defeat again and again without giving up. This is a winner's quality. You have that quality within you. Don't give up on yourself. Don't throw the towel in so quickly. Many people give up on the 1 yard line. And that's why most people never realize their personal greatness, because they're casual about life. And when you're casual about life, you will end up a casualty. Don't get caught up in, "Well, I tried it 4 or 5 times and things didn't work out." If there's something that you want and you're hungry for it, you've got to do whatever is necessary until. When you're hungry, you don't care about the facts. You don't care about the odds. And you've got to learn how to tune out the critics outside and the critic inside. And since I'm going to do this, I'm going to harness my will. And I'm not going to let anything stop me. I deserve this. I'm going to do it until. Once you find those things that will make it worth it for you, it is done. You know people. You've seen people that you can predict early on. That person is going to be a diamond. You know it. How they carry themselves, how they take care of business, how do they follow through, how they keep their commitments to their commitment, how they work the system, their energy level, their passion. You know it, the mark is on them, you know it. That one's going to make it. And people must see that in you. And we've all had experiences where we were working on something and we knew it was possible. We took the responsibility to make it happen. Other people couldn't see it. A lot of people didn't believe it. People were opposing you, but you kept on doing it. It was hard, it was rough, it was difficult, but to you, it was worth it. And eventually you got to a level, you know, there's nothing stopping me now. I'm on the move. I'm on the move.
There's gonna be things that go on that are out of your control. The worst thing you can do is let something that's out of your control control you. Get control of yourself, get control of your emotions. Don't get angry, don't get frustrated. Instead, stay calm and figure out how to move forward.
Things are gonna get harder, things are gonna get tougher. That's the way life works. So what you need to do is you need to get harder and you need to get tougher.
I'm talking to you, you're going through a storm right now. And I want you to know that this too shall pass, like every storm that has come to you. Every single storm, this too shall pass. Just because you fail don't make you a failure. And just because you lost don't make you a loser. Whatever you're going through right now, if you can just muster up enough strength to hold on and hold out. I don't care how long it takes you to finish school, hold on. I don't care how long it takes you to pass that bar exam, hold on and hold out. If you do not quit, if you do not give up, it's coming, baby. I want you to speak life into that thing. Whatever it is, you feel like, "I can't fail another test. I can't go through another day like this. I can't
can't handle it. Whatever your circumstances are, say with me, I can. I can get through this. I will. I will get through this. I must.
You're not a product of your environment. You're not a product of your external storm. What you have or what you don't have, where you come from or what you don't come from. The traumas, the abuses, the good and the bad. None of that dictates, but it's what you will do in the moment. What's your response? What you do matters. As long as there's breath in your lungs, there's hope in your heart. As long as you're breathing, yes, you can.
You have got to make a declaration that I am going to get through this. I am tougher than this. I'm bigger than this. I'm stronger than this. I will not surrender. Because whatever challenge is in front of me, it pales in comparison to the power within me. You have got to take full responsibility of your life. I got myself here. I can get myself out. And I am getting out. I am not going to be a volunteer victim.
You will take full ownership. It's my fault. It's my problem. I'm coming up with the solution for it. It's my fault. It's my problem. It's my solution. I'm taking ownership. You gotta increase your willpower because you're gonna go through it. You gotta look at life when life knocks you down and says, this all you got? The dark? Is this it? I was born in the dark, shaped in the dark, molded by the dark. I will break you because I lived in the dark. I trained in the dark. I became this person in the dark. You recycle your pain. You use your pain. You take your pain and let your pain push you to another level. Push you past what you ever thought you could do, what you ever thought you could be, what you ever thought you could have. You use your pain. You recycle it. I just need you to keep walking toward it.
I don't need you thinking about it no more. You're doing too much thinking. You're analyzing too much. You're talking yourself out of it. I don't know if this is going to work. I tried and it didn't work. I just need you to keep moving. I need you to make up in your mind that the only way you can lose is if you quit. I just need you to keep going.
They make diamonds by one, putting it under pressure, two, putting it under extreme heat, and three, they cut it. When it finishes going through all of that, you cannot break it.
I've been broken so much. I've been defeated so much. I've been disappointed so much in my life that I know what it feels like, and I can handle it.
Once you get to that point, you cannot be broken anymore.
Find that reason to wake up every day and go get it. Everybody's got a dream. Everybody's got a goal. But when you write your why down, what your why does for you is says, you can't quit. You can't give up. You can't stop.
Your spouse is going to push you. Your child is going to push you. The need to get better is going to push you. Because you're closer than you're ever going to be, it's going to push you. Your goals are going to push you. Your dreams are going to push you. The opportunity of a lifetime that happens in this particular time frame is going to push you. It's going to drive you.
You have to make a decision that I will learn from this thing. Every experience is my education. I have already made up my mind that I know I will fall down. I know that I will stumble, but I already see myself getting back up. Therefore, I'm never down. I'm either up or getting back up. I'm gonna learn.
You will never ever be successful until you turn your pain into greatness, until you allow your pain to push you from where you are to push you to where you need to be. Stop running from your pain and embrace your pain. Your pain is going to be a part of your prize, a part of your product. I challenge you to push yourself.
If you would be willing to fight your way through this battle, fight your way through cancer, fight your way through that academic struggle, fight your way through divorce, fight your way through that singing career, fight your way through boxing, fight your way through football. At the end of the fight is going to come victory.
I challenge you to never give up. You're gonna be here one day, but you'll never get here if you give up, if you give in, if you quit. And finally, guys, you gotta wanna succeed as bad as you wanna breathe.
And as you crawl up and out of that dismal and wretched place, as you rise above what you were, and as you take the form of who you are supposed to be, in the very act of standing up, in the very act of fighting on, you will become and you will remain unbroken.
Everybody in your life will have a turn back moment. No matter who you are, you're going to have such a period in your life where it seems like it's not working. You're going to have doubts. You're going to have a lot of trials and tribulations and challenges. You always have a moment in your life where the direction you're going You will have to make a decision to keep going or you turn back. The sad thing is, the average person turns back.
And it doesn't matter how you get knocked down in life, because that's gonna happen. All that matters is that you gotta get up.
Fall down, get back up again. Fall down, get back up again. Fall down, get back up again.
It ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done.
The hardships that we've had are actually the things that teach us the skills and the perspective we need to actually become what we want to be.
And if you quit, if you falter, if you stop, all the pain will be for nothing.
Now, if you know what you're worth, then go out and get what you're worth. But you got to be willing to take the hits and not pointing fingers saying you ain't where you want to be because of him or her or anybody. Cowards do that, and that ain't you. You're better than that.
I don't care how low you are. I don't care what you have done. I don't care what you have experienced. I don't care how devastated your life might appear to be. The shambles it might be in. Wherever you are in life, ladies and gentlemen, you've got comeback power. There's a power in you that can enable you to be stronger and better than anything that's out here. Once you begin to know who you are, once you discover this power, the perfect essence of who you are, that's in all of us, that's permeating our being, that enable us to be the directors of our lives. It will set you free from believing, I can't see myself doing any better. That you truly can live a healthy, happy, prosperous life, and that you can make it in what are called the worst of times. Tough times never last, but tough people do, and you are tough.
Whatever it is I want, this price is going to get much higher than this. It's going to get harder than this. And I've decided in advance it's going to be difficult, and I've decided in advance to stay in. I'm going to stay in the hunt. I'm going to stay fighting. I'm going to stay busting it. I'm going to pay the price until I get what it is that I deserve.
The people in life that win play offense, not defense. Stop backing into everything. Stand up. Bow your back a little bit. Start to walk a little different. Start to be that best version of you.
You have to resolve yourself today that you're going to win, that you're going to dominate, that you're not average and ordinary. There has to become a point where you make a decision. We're going to dominate. We're here to win. We are not here to play. And that takes some intestinal fortitude. It takes a decision. I'm where I'm at because I just flat decided. At some point, I get to choose who I am. The world doesn't tell me who I am.
And in every family, there's a the one that eventually shows up in a family. They rise up and changes the whole family forever. I'm the damn one. And in your family, you could be the one.
It's you. You've got to make it your personal business to make it happen. And you've got to resolve within yourself that I'm the one. I'm the one to make this happen. But you know it's going to be hard. But find out what will make it worth it for you. When life drops you to your knees, your reasons will help you get back up. Why are you here, Les? Because I want to make Mama proud of you. Why are you here, Les? I promise my kids I'm going to do for them. I'm going to give them a better life. I want to leave them a legacy. I'm not going to give up. Go back. Go back, fool. Go back. No, no. The people that are running after their dream know they're going to have hard times. They keep on running because they're saying within themselves, I'm the one. I'm the one. No matter how bad it is or how bad it gets, I'm going to make it.
If we looked at your background, you should have had a nervous breakdown and lost your mind. You should have given up by this point. You should have thrown in the towel on yourself already. You should have walked away by now. But there's something in your gut, in your heart, in your spirit, in your innermost being. That said, hold on. That instinct, that still small voice is about to turn your life around.
Regardless of the situation and circumstances, all the bad things happening around you, and what challenges you face now, you've got to believe in your heart of hearts that you can do it.
It's gonna be a dog fight. And if you're soft, you want to get out now. This is where you're like, I quit.
Whatever you want, you got to be willing to accept whatever come with it. Like, adversity is adversity. Opposition is opposition. But it's not so much about the opposition and the adversity that we face as it is about the perspective that we have about the opposition and adversity that we face.
When you want something, don't expect everybody to say, oh, come on in. Oh, you want this? Oh, great. We want to give this to you. You're such a nice person. You're doing it for your family, aren't you? Great.
No, no, life isn't like that. No, many doors will be closed in your face. Many loans that you will want. And they'll say, no, you don't have enough collateral. You don't have enough credit. And most people will give up. But you've got to decide that I'm going to be fearless and I'm going to go all out. I'm going to be relentless. I don't care how many no's I encounter. I refuse to be denied.
I challenge you to fight, to work, to not stop here, to believe so heavily in your aspirations that you too will not fear the word no, but instead you will choose to welcome it.
And when you want it as bad as you want to breathe, says, I'm willing to make any sacrifice. I'm willing to go through any pain. I'm willing to go through any suffering. I'm willing to go through whatever it takes. So when I get in there, I guarantee you at the end of it, I won't be the one that surrendered.
So as we look at the future, we can decide that from this day forward, as I look at all the dimensions of my life, looking at myself mentally, emotionally, and spiritually, I'm going to do all I can do to develop me, to bring my talent out here, to make a contribution to life. But is it easy? No. Is it worth it? Yeah. Yes, your life is worth it.
Our biggest challenge is to look at our own lives and ask the question, how am I holding myself back? Am I being as creative as I need to be? Am I using every resource I have? Am I turning up every rock to find what I'm looking for? Am I being unstoppable? Am I being relentless? The only thing that holds you back is the thing between your two ears, your own mind. If you can increase your self-belief and see yourself doing better, you will.
And the process is not supposed to be comfortable. So if it hurts, welcome to the big leagues. If you feel like you're under heat, praise God. If you feel like you're being pressured, praise God. But when God looks like he's pulling you back, eventually he gonna let you go. And the farther he pulls you back, once he releases you, boom. So when life happens, I don't just sit there and cry. I buck back.
We've come too far. We've been through too much. We've seen too much. We've had too many victories. We have seen defeat. We've looked defeat in the face, and we've overcome it. We've come too far to give up now. We've come too far to be negative now. We've come too far to start overthinking now.
Put yourself in a position where you can't retreat, where it's do or die, sink or swim. Here's what you'll find out. You'll develop incredible swimming skills. You'll find yourself stroking unlike you've ever seen before. Through the inspiration of desperation, you'll become more creative than ever before. Throw your whole self into it. See, most people go at it tentatively. They don't give all their stuff. They don't concentrate. You can't make a basket unless you shoot the ball. You can't hit a home run unless you take a swing at it. Most people won't even take a swing. If you want something, you've got to be relentless. You've got to decide, I deserve this, and I'm going to have it. And you go all out to get it.
The spirit of resiliency, the spirit of grit, it's in your DNA. It's in your blood. Overcoming is in your blood. Getting through adversity is in your blood. We need to focus on where we're going, not where we come from and what's happening.
You gotta tell life, I don't know who you've been dealing with, but you ain't dealt with me. You gotta tell bankruptcy. You gotta tell divorce. You gotta tell sickness. I don't know who you've been dealing with, but you come up against the wrong one this time.
You can be and do whatever you want, and nobody can stop you. Nobody can stop you but you.
If I can take it, I can make it.
If you can take it, you can make it.
If you can just keep believing when nothing in you is working, when all your external forces have given way, if you can just manage to somehow keep hoping, you have a chance. You just can't become hopeless.
If you can just keep hope alive, you can make it. Because if you keep hoping, it is really faith. You just gotta transpose it into I hope this happened to I believe this can happen.
Life is like a grindstone. It can polish you or it can pulverize you, depending on how you position yourself.
There's one side of pain that's the suffering and the discomfort side of pain. But then there's another side of pain that's called effort. It's called glory. It's called if you can find a way to push through pain, there's something greater on the other side of it.
Do I just sit there and settle? No, I don't. I say enough's enough, man, and I'm gonna make a change and I'm gonna keep going until I get it. You chase something that you believe you deserve until you get it. And it doesn't matter what happens to you. Doesn't matter how many times you've been fired. Doesn't matter how many people don't believe in you. Just go until you get it.
Say it and actually mean it. Look in the mirror every fucking day and say, yeah, I'm proud of you. I believe in you. You can do anything you want. You are powerful.
You say, if it's hard, then do it hard. I won't allow this to stop me. I don't have the option of easy. I don't have the option, and I don't think you do, or any of us do, of going around trying to find a dream that's a little dream that doesn't require much responsibility or not too stressful or won't be too much of a hassle.
No, no, no.
All you need to do to get out in the arena of life is to say, it's possible. In spite of the no's, yes, maybe this next call might do. It's possible. This next job interview, this might be the one. I can do this.
Every day you wake up, you gotta start with that vision. You gonna get up, you gonna get dressed, you gonna get out, and you gonna do what you've been called to do. And you gonna prove to everybody that tried to break you, everybody that tried to stop you, everybody that tried to kill your dream, you gonna prove all of them wrong.
You've got to say yes. Yes to my dreams. Yes to me. Yes, I can. Doesn't matter how many failures I've made. Doesn't matter how many mistakes I've endured. Doesn't matter about what I've done. I can make it.
And you got to believe even if there's no reason to believe. When everything appears to be going wrong, you're working on your dreams, and somebody that you love and trust decide to walk out on you, you still got to believe. When you see those things that you've been working on crumble in your face, you still got to believe. When friends who should be a source of strength and encouragement, relatives who should be there to inspire you and motivate you and tell you, you can't do it, you still got to believe. With no money in your pocket and many times more month left at the end of the month than after your money, you don't know how you're going to make it. You know your paycheck's long before you get it. You still got to believe. I don't care what it takes. I don't care how many speeches I have to give, how many seminars I have to give. I know I ain't got the money. I know I don't have the education, but I ain't gonna let that stop me. I'm gonna do it.
And no matter what you're going through, as long as you still have breath in your body, as long as you're still alive, you're still in the game.
Because anytime you wake up and you don't have a white chalk outline around your body, it's a great day.
If I just stand long enough, I can pull this off. I can do it.
I'm putting it out here. I'm not going to rest until I have it. It's necessary. I'm going to do it. It's on me. No one's going to make it happen for me. I get some help and assistance, but I know that it's on me. Will it be easy? No, it's going to be hard. But it doesn't matter what it costs. Because whatever you have to do, it's worth it because it's your life's purpose. And once you know that, it is done. It's possible you can live your dream.
And if life's got you backed up, you can't quit. You can't give up. You can't stop.
You fail a class, get back up and try again. You lose a job, get back up and try again. You put all your money in investment, get back and try it again. If you start a business and it don't work, don't stop, don't quit.
You will study as long as it takes. You won't go to sleep until you have the knowledge that it takes to do what you're able to do.
If you do what is easy, your life will be hard.
You do what is easy. Complain about your situation, your circumstances. Stand around and be a volunteer victim like everybody else. Surrender and give up on your dreams. Become depressed and bitter and angry. Anybody can do that. If you do what is easy, your life will be hard. But if you do what is hard, keep coming back again and again and again. Get up dressed every day, knowing some way, somehow, with a spirit of expectation, I can do this. If you do that over and over and over again, your life will be easy.
All of us, at some time or another, have agonized over making a decision. Some decisions are major decisions, and also there are a lot of small decisions that we don't make, that they tax our minds, they drain our energy, they create a lot of anxiety and nervousness and mental torment. Because we don't take care of it. We decide not to decide, which is a decision.
Imagine you're on your deathbed, and standing around your deathbed are the ghosts representing your unfulfilled potential. The ghost of the ideas you never acted on. The ghost of the talents you didn't use. And they're standing around your bed, angry, disappointed, and upset. They say, we came to you because you could have brought us to life, they say. And now we have to go to the grave together. So I ask you today, how many ghosts are going to be around your bed when your time comes?
How much time do you spend working on you? How much time do you spend every day working on your dream? What kind of investment have you made in you?
If your mentality is,
I can't wait to see what happens great to me in 2022. You are going to get fucking sh** as a result. Life does not reward people who wait to see what happens. What you put in, you will get out. So if you want 2022 to actually be different, you have to not only be willing to visualize and manifest, you have to be willing to grit it out. You have to be willing to push through discomfort. Nothing that you're about to try or do or achieve that is worthwhile is going to be comfortable for you during the process of creating it. And I want you to take the word hope and I want you to throw it on the motherfucking ground and I want you to replace it with the word I will fucking do in 2022.
Woe be unto you if you go into another year and waste another year with the old mentality while somebody's in the hospital begging God for the opportunity that you have right now. You better step into this moment.
You're only here for a short time. If you're not going to show people what's possible, who the fuck else is? Who's going to show your kids? Who's going to show your aunts and uncles? Who's going to show your fucking nieces and nephews? Are you going to fail those people? Are you going to buy into the narrative that you can't?
Stand up for your dreams. Stand up for what you want in your life. Decide that your life is so meaningful to you, that you love you and you love life so much that you're going to stand up for something you want. You don't want to be a spectator. You want to get out in the field where the action is, and you will be amazed. After the struggle, there will be a calm period and things will begin to click for you. Come out here with what you got. You don't have enough money? Don't worry about it. You got the dream. You must be patient, persistent, and positive no matter what.
But aren't there some guarantees you can give us?
Yes.
You're going to die. You can't get out of life alive. So I'm saying to you, you got 6 months to live. Live your life now. Live your dreams now.
Everybody know what to do when everything goes right. Everybody know to show up and give everything they got when the sun shines. Everybody, when they get what they want, they're gonna come and they're gonna be great. But it's very few people that reach deep down and got the character that in the midst of opposition, in the midst of a challenge, to look at it with the right perspective, and not only look at it with the right perspective, process it the right way, and figure out a way to use it.
What is it that will make it worth it for you? When you wanna give up, and things are working against you, to face the rejections. What is it that will make it worth it for you? To brainstorm and not be intimidated and say, I can do this. What is it that will make it worth it for you to make know your vitamin, that you become empowered by it? What is it that will make it worth it for you to raise the bar on yourself and say, I got some more stuff in me, when you want to keep driving past the office because of the stress? What is it that will help you get back up again?
Some of us choose to stay down, but it's that motherfucker who constantly gets up as fast as they can. Those are the motherfuckers that make it in life.
All you do is you fall down, get back up again, fall down, get back up again, fall down, get back up again. That's how you win.
You've got to activate the thinker in you. Don't allow your emotions to control you. We are emotional, but you want to begin to discipline your emotion. If you don't discipline and contain your emotions, they will use you.
You want to monitor your inner conversations, the things that you say to yourself. You want to watch them, and in watching them, you want to take charge. Oh, you really don't feel like it. You really don't need to do it. Forget all that. That's that inner conversation. Oh, you don't need to worry about trying to go into your own business. Forget that. You can't do that. What if you lose everything you've got? That inner conversation that stops you from doing the things you want to do less, don't do that. Forget all that. And then I said, shut up. You'll get scared sometimes. Your mind will go blank on you. You've got to learn to stand up to yourself inside yourself. And short circuit, override that conversation that's always going on. 85% of what that conversation will tell you is negative. It will tell you you're tired when you really are not tired. It will tell you you can't do it. It will fill you with fear. So you've got to watch that conversation. And when you find it going on, you've got to stand up to it and say, I'm gonna do this anyhow. I'm afraid, but I'm afraid not to do it. And I'm not going to let you stop me. You got to stand up inside yourself sometimes and say, shut up. Some people you will allow to unnerve you. You can't do this. You don't have everything it takes. Now, shut up.
I have got to do it. That's why you've got to learn to make a conscious, deliberate, determined effort to stand up inside yourself. Working on yourself, watching that inner dialogue, it will determine the quality of your life.
The biggest challenge that you will have in life is you. Because there's no enemy within. The enemy outside can do us no harm.
You've got to sell yourself every day on your abilities, on what you're doing, on the goal that you want to reach.
You're bombarded with negative stuff every day that beats you down, and you will find yourself unconsciously engaged in self-destructive behavior. If you don't program yourself, life will program you.
Don't complain. Don't talk negative. Average people use their time to complain. Average people talk problems. The greats talk solutions.
Live your life with passion, with some drive. Decide that you're going to push yourself.
You want to live life with energy and passion. You want to be happy. You got a lot to be thankful for.
Most people won't do that. Most people give up on themselves easily. You know the human spirit is powerful? There's nothing as powerful. It's hard to kill the human spirit.
You gotta get this beast mode. Everything about you has to say, I ain't playing. If it's to have, I'm gonna get it. And I ain't leaving none of it behind. It's my beast mode. If you wanna get your butt out to bed, grind from sunup to sundown, you can have the life that other people dream of.